Hi there, welcome back. In this video, I will tell you about your energy demand and the related greenhouse gas emissions. In the last 200 years, the world has seen a tremendous increase in energy demand. And we all know that this energy demand is likely to increase further. What are the reasons for this increase? Well, we are more and more people living on this planet, our living standards increase, and as a result, for instance, the amount of appliances that we use at home, that we have at home, are increasing. So just think about more mobiles, more routers, more tablets, or whatever else you have at home. In principle, there's nothing wrong with an increase in energy demand, as long as you would supply this energy in a sustainable way. Unfortunately, our energy supply is currently not sustainable. From the beginning of the industrialization, caused by the invention of the steam engine, the development of the last 200 years is closely linked to the use of fossil fuels. And this is causing massive environmental problems. So where does your energy come from? Take a look at this picture from the global energy mix. Like I said before, our energy is mainly coming from fossil fuels. That is coal, oil, and gas. A smaller fraction is coming from nuclear energy. The remaining part of 15 to 20% is coming from what we consider as renewable energy sources. Be aware that renewable does not automatically mean it is also sustainable. Among these energy sources, prominent are two things. The use of traditional biomass, mainly in developing countries, that means burning of wood, for instance, for cooking and heating. And on the other hand side, the use of hydroelectricity via large-scale dams, like you can find, for example, the one at the Three Gorges Dam in China. All the other energy sources you hear so much about in the media, on the internet, in the news, like photovoltaic, like wind power, or all the other things that are popping up, are actually producing a rather small fraction of our current energy demand. Both the increasing energy demand and the focus of our energy supply on fossil fuels have caused a tremendous increase in greenhouse gas emissions over the last 100 years. So when you look at the emissions of many countries all over the globe, you can see that they've increased the greenhouse gas emissions by several 100% over the last 100 years. Currently, countries like, let's say, India, China, and Indonesia have a comparably low output of greenhouse gas emissions per person. Now, if you would imagine that they would increase their greenhouse gas emissions per person to the same level like, let's say, the United States or the United Arab Emirates, and this is actually something that could happen if they continue their current economic growth, you can directly see what additional negative impact that possible development might have on our climate and environment. So, why then rely still so much on fossil fuels? There's one main argument that makes fossil fuels really attractive in comparison to other energy sources, and that is its energy density. So, for instance, 1 kilogram of gasoline has an energy density of about 12 to 15 kilowatt hours per kilogram, while biomass only has an energy density of 1.5 to 3 kilowatt hours per kilogram. So, 5 times more in here than in here. How much energy actually is now 1 kilowatt hour? Well, kilowatt hour is about the amount of energy you need to heat up 1,000 kilograms of water by a bit less than 1 degree centigrade. So with this jerry can, you can actually heat up 4,000 liters of water for 1 degree, while this piece of wood only would be enough for 1,000 liters. There are two more reasons why fossil fuels can be attractive. Well, combustion technologies like we use in power plants are really far developed and readily available. And on the other hand side, fossil fuels are still rather comparably cheap in comparison to the alternatives, and they're still available in abundance. So different countries have a different energy demand depending on lifestyle, on living standards, and degree of industrialization. So you have countries like the US or United Arab Emirates with an energy demand of more than 80,000 kilowatt hours per person per year, while other less developed countries like, let's say, Ghana or Yemen use less than one-tenth of that amount. So, for what do you actually use energy at home? Let's take a look at an average household in the US. Here, more than 50% of the total energy demand is related to thermal comfort. That means heating of buildings, cooling of buildings and the provision of warm water. The remaining fraction is used for electronic devices, lighting, and appliances like vacuum cleaners. One important thing to realize is the fraction of the energy demand related to thermal comfort is highly depending on the climate and where you are on the globe. So let's say in colder climates like in Norway, you could expect an increase in heating demand while you need less energy for cooling, while for subtropical countries and tropical countries like India or Singapore, cooling becomes the dominant fraction of your energy demand. Do you know how much energy you use in your household, and do you know how much CO2 you emit by that?